Today we will discuss about the use of break and continues. Let's take an example. We have taken a variable I and initialized it with 1. Now use while loop. Within while loop, just write I is less than equal to 10. Now put curly braces. Within curly braces, display printf hello in one line, and then printf world. Before hello, just put a slash n. Here semicolon, increment the loop by writing I plus plus. What this program will do, it will start with I is equal to 1 and continue till the value of I is 10. So this loop will be executed 10 times, and every time it will display hello and in the same line world, hello world. So this program is basically to display hello world 10 times. So we will start with I is equal to 1. Then condition is tested, value of I is 1, so we will get inside the loop, condition is true. So printf slash n, it will take you to new line, hello will be displayed, and in the next printf statement we have written world, so it will display world. Then in the next statement we are writing I plus plus, so this I plus plus will increase the value of I by 1. Now it will test the condition, 2 is less than equal to 2, yes condition is true, again it will be repeated. It will continue till the value of I is 10. Once the value of I becomes 11, it will take you outside the loop, then get ch will be executed. Now just run the program and see the output. It is displaying hello world 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 times. Now use break anywhere in the program. Say I am writing it here, break, and then put a semicolon. Now again compile the program and check the output. You will notice that will display hello world only once. So why it is executing it only once? Because the role of break is to terminate the loop once it is encountered. So when break is encountered, it will take you outside the loop. So loop is terminated. It doesn't matter whether the condition is true or false. So break will immediately take you outside the loop. So when the value of I is 1, condition is tested, condition is true, it will display hello world, and then break is encountered. So loop is terminated and you are taken directly outside the loop, and it will execute get ch. So break is basically used in a program to terminate something, whether it's loop or whether it's switch case. In the same way, we can investigate the use of continue. What we are doing here, we are just writing the statement after I plus plus, and now I am writing here continue. So what will happen here, if you will enter the loop and test the condition, condition is true as the value of I is 1, so it will display hello, and value of I is incremented by 1. Now continue is uncountered. What continue will do, it will not allow you to go further down in the loop. It will ask you to return back and test the condition. So in this way, world will not display. So only It will display hello how many times? It will display 10 times hello. Just check the output. You can see that hello is displayed. How many times? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10 times. So this is the basic role of a container.